All right. So now, I'm resorting away from myself, and I'm trying to. Gosh, dang it! I have a cousin. She's older than me now. She's maybe 10 years older or so. Yeah, around 10, maybe less. But she needs. I'll go back to Cupid. I am a former Cupid, and so I guess I am current Cupid also. I don't know if I can drop the act. She's there, and she is today out sporting around in the city of Dallas. And she's wearing, what is she wearing? She's wearing those polka dots of they're like the leopard, the black and the white leopard with the, like, it's almost like a Dalmatian from a distance. But I'm like, well, what's the deal? She's looking extra beautiful today. Extra beautiful. And I'm like, she's almost radiant. So I'm thinking, gosh dang it, it's a day. So I'm gonna push out extra that a guy finds her, because this is ridiculous. She can't go on and on and on and on without having a for sure. And I think, you know, just a for sure, like, you know, just even a dater guy, you know, just, you know, she likes to be by herself. She's very demanding in that activity, but maybe, you know, for sure, like 3 days a week or something type of guy. I mean, this is ridiculous. She's young still. She's too young to give up, and forfeit. You know what I'm saying? It's too young. So and she's lost like weight since I've been here. So I don't know what's the deal. I'm causing her to skinny. So that's another thing I forgot. I cause people to get thinner, apparently. That's an odd thing. So if I move in with you, I'll make you thinner. So that's extra ridiculous. Now, yeah, she's out there. She's out there in her black and white, and so we need to find her. We need to find her and catch her, and go. Oh my goodness, yeah. Oh my goodness, there is a woman available, and gosh dang it. Yeah, she's strong. She's strong-spirited. More about her. She's very strong-spirited, very right mentalist in everything, and she's director of companies type. So because of this, she's perhaps been difficult in the find for a man. Maybe a man is just like, what the heck? You know, who's the charge here? Who's in charge? And so, yeah, so it's been a conflict because she's the boss. But she's an excellent cook. Excellent cook, and my gosh, she should, you know, and in the shouldisms, she should have a restaurant with all of these recipes, amazing recipes from the family. But I'm not cooking them, and she is. She knows everything. She brings it back from the grandma's, and she's the one who carries it through, and it's like, wow. So I like that type of food, and I think she's quite successful at it. So she makes the man happy for that, even just for the 3 days a week, you know. So there. That type of relationship is interesting for her, I believe so, because I think she's been so happy to be without the man in her life, that it has become an almost, what do we call it, a blasphemous experience to even endeavor in the fact of living with a man for a moment. And yet she has now another grandchild possible on the way. And so I'm like, well, this man in her life has to be like, what do we call that, the kiddie acceptor. And I say a kiddie acceptor, maybe even go out with her and the children, because they babysit, because she babysits the children. So it'll have to be this type that is like, yeah, we'll go out and babysit the children together. So it has to be this type of man who is going for it. The children, choking. I'm choking on something, I'm sorry. But yeah. Yeah, but that would be funny, because then he'd be like a grandpa for the little yabo. You know what I mean? A grandpa. Because there's two of them, and it's like, it's real. You have to have help. You can't be just like this woman alone in the house by herself with these two children and having to feed them their dumplings or whatever. It's, you know, get a man to help you sometimes. And so I'm like, it has to be like a grandpa character. So we need to get a grandpa character for her. And that's the way it goes. Is that enough said about her? Like I said, she's extremely independent, so you're free also. However, you have to be committal to being a grandpa. So then that would be part of the deal. And And she's very sexy. She's very full. What do we call them? The more of a full shape of a woman, with the bosoms, everything. And yeah, she's very, very interesting in knowledge. She's very well traveled. She's had many businesses, and yeah, she's a strong person. That is the reason, maybe why you would have 4 days other elsewhere, and that's okay, and maybe so that's better for you also. Maybe you already know that to expect in women anyway. So yeah, so that's funny. And she is actually quite humorous, if you can get through her dark side. She's actually a very, very dark humor, so it's there. It's there. She is humorous lady, and yeah. So anyway, oh yeah. I know, this is a cute bra. I really love them, and then I found out later I bought it that it has like that space in there that you're supposed to put the padding, and so somebody took the padding out of the bra, and I bought the bra without the padding specifically because I didn't want this extra poof, and now I'm missing it. I'm missing it. It's like, well, maybe that's a qualification. I have to have the extra poof in order to attract a man. You know, they need the fake. So I don't know. I don't know. Just gets ridiculous. Yeah. So I don't know if I should go back to Tarjay and say I'm missing the poofs of the brassiere. Yeah.